The country's anti-trafficking council urged to consult with concerned sectors to improve their new departure rules for overseas-bound Filipinos. The Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry asserts the new protocols are an added burden to travelers. See, under the new rules, Filipinos traveling abroad will have to bring more than their basic travel documents. The new policy, which takes effect next month, is part of government's efforts to crack down on human trafficking.
Natatamaan yung marami na yung taong bayan natin, lalo na yung mga first-time traveler. Dapat mag-consult naman sila sa private sector, sa mga travel agency, sa mga yung mga agency ahensya na nagpadala ng tao sa labas. Plan it well, execute it now with the streamlined operation in mind.
Authorities and lawmakers inspect rice warehouses in Bulacan as part of efforts to prevent rice hoarding. Let's get details now from our very own Jervis Manahan. He joins us on the line. Jervis, what more can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina, several congressmen together with the Bureau of Customs did a surprise inspection in four rice warehouses in Balagtas and Bukawe, Bulacan. This comes a day after President Bongbong Marcos ordered the BOC to intensify operations and exhaust all legal means to control the price of rice. The delegation was led by House Speaker Martin Romualdez himself. They found thousands of sacks of rice stored in the warehouses. In total, 154,000 sacks of mostly imported rice and 60,000 sacks of palay were seen in the mills. These were suspected to be smuggled and hoarded. The warehouses were ordered to be temporarily closed until the owners can prove that they are operating legitimately. They are given 15 days to present necessary documents. If they fail to do so, the sacks of rice will be seized and donated to either the Department of Agriculture or the DSWD. If they get to present valid documents, they will be ordered to release the rice in the market. One of the owners said that the closure will just hamper their operations and this will affect supply of rice in Metro Manila. Carmina.
All right, Jervis, just a couple of questions for you. What do we know about the owners? How long have they been in business?
Most of the owners here have been operating for very long years now because these mills are inside the intercity estate where there are hundreds of mills operating. So this is actually known to be one of the centers of rice milling in the entire central zone.
Mm-hmm. And tell us about the trail that led the representatives there, Speaker Martin Romualdez and Congressman Erwin Tulfo.
I'm sorry, Carmina, what was the question?
Tell us about the trail that led the congressman there. What were they following?
Actually, they just there were information that reached the Bureau of Customs about possible hoarding and smuggling. So actually, House Speaker Romualdez and Congressman Erwin Tulfo just joined the operatives from Bureau of Customs who are acting after the orders of President Bongbong Marcos to intensify operations. So a representative of the BOC told us that they have received intelligence information that these warehouses are involved in smuggling. So the lawmakers went here to check if it's actually happening.
And as you said earlier, the owners now have 15 days to prove otherwise that they are in the business of legitimate rice importation and distribution, is it, and not hoarding and smuggling?
Yes, one of the owners of the mills actually talked to the media earlier this morning and said that they are actually operating legitimately, they are not hoarding, and that they are releasing rice on a daily basis. So they say that closure, although temporary, will actually affect the receivers of their supplies, who are retailers of rice in several markets in Metro Manila.
And how long will they be, how long is the order to close them? How long would that take, their closure?
Well, they will be closed until they can prove that they're operating legitimately. So within 15 days, they will have to present the documents. And if they get to present the valid documents, they will be ordered to reopen and release the rice to the market.
All right. We're going to have to leave it at that. Jervis Manahan there joining us on the line. Several groups warn electricity prices may go up following the Philippine Energy Department's order mandating distribution utilities to procure part of their supply from gas-powered facilities. They insist the DOE's order has no legal basis.
Kapag humindi ang DOE at sinabi niya na hindi ko kailangan ng gas, mas magmamahal ang presyo ng kuryente ko kapag nag-gas ako, or mas gusto ko mag-RE, they could actually be penalized.
Simple lang magiging resulta na to. Dependency sa fossil gas, dependency sa imported na mahal na klase ng source ng electricity. So, dagdag pahirap ito doon sa, kumbaga, hirap na mga electric consumers.
Well, the Energy Department admits power rates may go up, but it says the order is needed to ensure stable power supply in the country.
We're trying to push LNG so that we can finally do away with coal. Eh, hindi pa pwedeng mag-go away kasi wala pang nag-build ng planta, wala pang nag-import or nag-explore. So we need to push that. It's not renewable, but I do believe it's greener than coal.
The Philippine Treasury Bureau has released the implementing rules and regulations of the country's first sovereign investment fund. These will take effect by September 12th. Philippine Finance Chief Benjamin Diokno says the search has begun for the president and CEO of the corporation that will manage the fund. The rules specify the sources of government's 50 billion peso contribution to the Maharlika Investment Fund. It will come from 100% of the dividends of the Philippine Central Bank, its 10% share from the income of the Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation, 10% of revenues from other government-owned gaming operators, and proceeds from the privatization of government assets. The law creating the Maharlika Fund was signed by President Marcos in July, despite strong opposition from various sectors. Philippine ICT Secretary Ivan John Oy unveils plans to improve the Marcos administration's so-called eGovPH super app. It was created to give the public access to government services on their phones through a single application. It also aims to strengthen the ease of doing business in the country. Secretary Oy says they are working on adding new features to the app, including a system that allows users to pay for their transactions.
eGovPay. So the payment channel, so that when you now transact with government, you can use that eGovPay. eGovPay we will be launching soon, and we'd like to do it as agnostic as possible, so you can use all payment channels at your choice. Eventually, we'd like to put a rating system into that.
That's a good one.
Public now will be able to rate, okay, which LGU did I have the best service, or which department? Yeah. Then now we will have a more transparent government.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. pays tribute to the late broadcaster Mike Enriquez. Enriquez, whose career in journalism spanned decades, passed away Tuesday at the age of 71. In a social media post, Marcos called him a pillar in the broadcasting industry, who dedicated his life to delivering unbiased news to the Filipino people. Enriquez was best known as one of the anchors of GMA's flagship newscast, 24 Horas, and the host of the long-running public affairs program, Investigador. Our condolences to the Enriquez family and to his GMA colleagues, also our colleagues in the broadcasting industry. He will be missed.